Jesusness. And so I take it out of the old and also the new, because I want to say that Jesus is the God of both testaments. He's the God of the old and the God of the new. Now, if you believe in God and don't believe in Jesus, you got a problem. To believe in God and not believe in Jesus is to believe in water and not believe in ice. To believe in God and not believe in Jesus is to believe in rock and don't believe in stone. To believe in God and not believe in Jesus is to believe in Nashville and don't believe in country music. To believe in God and don't believe in Jesus is to believe in apostolic and don't believe in Jesus' name. You cannot believe in one and not believe in the other. So you cannot believe in God and not believe in Jesus. In the Old Testament, Jesus is veiled. But in the New Testament, Jesus is unveiled. The Old Testament, Jesus is wrapped. New Testament, Jesus unwrapped. The Old Testament is the intimate Jesus, but the New Testament is the ultimate Jesus. The Old Testament is Jesus the innermost, but the New Testament is Jesus the uttermost. The Old Testament is Jesus contained, but the New Testament is Jesus explained. The Old Testament is Jesus concealed, but the New Testament is Jesus revealed. The Old Testament, you may be seated. The Old Testament is Jesus enfolded, but the New Testament is Jesus unfolded. The Old Testament is the intimate Jesus. The New Testament is the ultimate Jesus. The Old Testament is the panoramic Jesus. The New Testament is the psychoramic Jesus. The Old Testament is Jesus in picture. The New Testament is Jesus in person. The Old Testament is Jesus in shadow. The New Testament is Jesus in substance. The Old Testament is Jesus in ritual. The New Testament is Jesus in reality. The Old Testament is the eternity of Jesus, and the New Testament is the paternity of Jesus. But it don't matter whether it's the old or the new, Jesus is the God of both testaments, and there's nobody like Jesus. There's nobody like Jesus.